light this candle as a reminder that Jesus Christ is the light of the world and walks with us each and every day. Thanks be to God. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, everyone. Nice to see you all. Nice to see you. Nice to see you all joining us from Facebook Live. It's always great to have you join with us for service in this new way of being. So this is Peace Sunday. This is the Sunday in the church calendar year where we focus on peace. And so today our worship service will be focused in and around peace. So peace be with you. Thank you. Good job. So the life and work of the congregation, the announcements, let's go through them. So this week at church, there were announcements printed. They were left at the back of the church. They haven't been touched for 72 hours. So if you wanted to pick one up, either on your way in or on your way out, they do have them printed for you so you can take them home. And there might be some extra information there that I won't be sharing right now. This week we have building on Tuesday and Wednesday. Next Sunday is the All Saints service for Sunday, and it's actually All Saints Day, November 1st. So we will be having a special worship at that time. It's going to look a little different than it has in years past, but we still will be taking time to remember those who have passed before us in this past year. And then at 2 p.m. on All Saints Sunday, we have a session meeting that's going to take place upstairs here in the sanctuary, so all session members who are encouraged to join in our session meeting next Sunday at 2 p.m. Where we work out and plan things around worship. The other things coming up, there's more upcoming meetings. So November 1st is a session meeting, November 8th is a stewards meeting at 6:30, and November 15th is the official board meeting. So the official board meeting, a regular official board meeting, will be on November 15th at 2 p.m. There's information about masks in the handout that the St. Paul Quilters do have masks for sale. And there's information about the elevator, and that was on the announcements too, that we are looking each person to give $10 per year to cover the expense of the elevator. And so you can make that as a one-time donation, or you can spread it over the year, however you like. The information is, like I said, on the announcements. Sunday school is going to start next Sunday, November 1st. It's going to look a little different than it has in the past, but it will be running, and we're very excited about that. To accommodate the regulations around COVID-19, the Sunday school will be going in the downstairs door at around before 11. Sunday school will start at 11 downstairs, and church service will be upstairs. And so there won't be the traffic of Sunday school going in between. So Sunday school will just run during the same time that church runs, but it will be downstairs and church will be upstairs. And then they will alternate weeks between being upstairs and being downstairs. But you can ask Erica about all of those details. But I'm excited that Sunday school is starting. The turkey takeout dinners, tickets are still being sold, and you can pick them up from Evie, or you can pick them up after church. So, and ask somebody if you want some. We'll find a way to get them to you. And also in the bulletin, there is a job opportunity, a part-time custodian here at St. Paul United Church. It's really small to read up there, but all of that information is in the bulletin handout. Is there anything else that I forgot? Yes?
The time changes next Sunday.
Oh, no, really?
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's when we get the hour back. Yeah. Oh, okay. Okay, that's when we're all early to church. Okay, so next Sunday, the church time changes. Not the church time. The time changes. The time zone changes. And we get our hour back. And we can all sleep in again. And it's going to be exciting. Is there anything else coming for the church at this time? So, as we now enter into this time of worship, Let us join together in community, both here and online. Let us join together in community as we say our creed, and we are allowed to speak quietly into our masks and to pray quietly into our masks. So let us join together in our call to worship as we meditate and speak quietly the words of our new creed. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life, in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. God of all nations and all people, we open ourselves to you in this time of worship and know that you are, that your caring presence is as close as the air we breathe. We praise you for the wonder of worship and for this time together. We thank you for your long-lasting love and for your call to us to care for our neighbors as we love and care for ourselves. Bless us and guide us this day as we enlarge our circle to a world in need, following Jesus' prophetic way of justice and loving kindness. O God, you not only welcome us, you receive us into yourself. Give us courage to be so open to others, and let them become so dear to us that we might share not only your gospel, but also our lives. We ask in Jesus' name, amen. Our offerings have been gathered as you have joined together in worship this day. The offering plate was available as you entered. It also will be available as you leave. For those of you joining with us online, there are many different ways to share your offering. E-transfer, Canada Helps, all different ways. If you want to find out more about those ways, it is listed on the Facebook page and in the bulletin. And we are so grateful for all the different ways in which you give to our church. So the offerings made today, for the offerings given this week, for the many ways we continue to support and sustain this important ministry of this congregation and of the church in the world, we are thankful. Let us pray. Compassionate and loving God, accept these gifts so that they may work in our world to soften hard hearts and to open closed minds. We know your kingdom is at work in this world. May compassion, grace, and love bless and enliven the ministry these gifts support here in our own community and in the world around us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Our opening hymn today is Morning Has Broken.
Thank you.
pray. O God, your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Let us listen for your word for us today. Amen. So we are continuing to read in the Gospel of Matthew. And did anyone bring a Bible this week? BYOB? Come on. Come on. I know, you're just excited. Thank you. Good job. I'm glad you brought yours. Perfect. Will you read along with me, Cameron? Good. No, you don't have to read it aloud. We'll read just silently together. This, we're reading in Matthew, and we're following along in this gospel, and this long conversation is continuing. It started when Jesus was disrupting everything happening in the temple, and after he went inside, all of these different groups are coming up to him and questioning him and trying to entrap him, trying to catch him saying something wrong. He's also sharing with them how he feels they have gone wrong. So it's a real trial of the religious institution that Jesus finds himself in. And he's questioning their motives. He's questioning what they're doing, and as well as they are questioning him. And so, at this point, they're kind of getting toward the end. Everybody has tried to catch him up, and nobody has been successful. And so, when we come to this part of the reading, it's the end of chapter 22, chapter 22, verse 34. Oops, just a sec. And he is asked another question by the group called the Pharisees. So it reads, when the Pharisees heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. He said, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." This is our scripture today, according to Matthew. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Loving God, lead us in your truth and teach us in your word. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So today is Peace Sunday. It is the Sunday in the calendar year where we focus on peace. And we ask ourselves, what does that mean? What does peace mean? What does peace mean in the world? And what does peace mean to us personally in our own lives? In the church, we take this opportunity to preach and teach and reflect on what the gospel, what the good news has to say and has been revealed to us through Jesus. So this is our focus when we preach about peace on this Sunday. And we ask ourselves, what does peace mean? What does peace mean to you? When you think of peace, what do you picture? Is it the absence of war in the world? Is it the absence of conflict within our own lives? Well, the Bible would have us know that it's something more than that. It's more than just the absence of conflict. It's more than just the absence of war. It's something better in its place. The word for peace in Hebrew is shalom. In Greek is Irene. And shalom means complete. Shalom means whole. When you say peace in Hebrew, you're saying completeness, wholeness, working together. All of the many pieces of the world, not only without conflict, but working together. Jesus offers his peace to the world, his completeness, his wholeness when he says, "My peace I give you." This is the completeness and the wholeness that we see in Jesus. So peace is not just an absence of conflict, but requires taking what is broken and restoring it to wholeness. So not just walking away from conflict, but repairing the broken relationship of that conflict. So when we come to Peace Sunday, we ask ourselves, do we have peace? Do we have peace in the world? Do we have peace in our own personal lives? Is there peace in our community, in our province, in our country, in the world? We know the answer. And sometimes it's overwhelming just how much conflict there is. Just how much conflict we see in our day-to-day. Sometimes just watching the news and watching and hearing about all of this fighting and conflict and hostility that people have toward one another. People acting with selfishness without seeking restoration and wholeness. It can be overwhelming. And it can make us throw up our hands and go, how can this change? It's too much. It's hopeless. This is not what we're taught in Scripture. We're taught that peace starts with us. Peace starts with us individually, each and every one of us. And it's no coincidence that today the scripture from the gospel is this one. That the scripture from the gospel is, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. If we actually lived that out, if we actually lived out that kind of peace, can you imagine what the world would be if each person lived it out? Today's gospel, Jesus is in the temple, and he's continued to be asked by questions by those religious authorities who are in charge, and he continues to not only thwart their attempt to catch him, but he's teaching them, and he's stretching them, and he's causing them to rethink the way that they have been running things. And he draws from the scriptures that they already knew, these commandments. You see, at the time, in the Israelite tradition, there were 365 commandments that the Pharisees would have been upholding. The Pharisees would have been making sure that everyone follows. And so they're kind of trying to trick him by asking him which one is the most important, because they would believe they all are. But he does answer them appropriately. Because these are the most important, and everything else is tied to them. And not only tied to them, but they are tied to each other. You can't have one without the other. Loving God means loving all of creation. God is in and through all of creation. To love God means that you love not only the sky and the world and the creatures and the environment, you love the people of the world. You can't love God completely and totally with your whole heart, mind, body, and soul without loving your neighbor, regardless of who that neighbor is, whether they're next door or on the other side of the world, whether they are the same political mind as you or whether they are the opposite, whether you agree completely with them or not, we are called to love and peace. Loving God should be at the core of our faith, but it's incomplete by itself. If our love for God doesn't translate into loving our neighbors, no matter where that neighbor is, or even worse, if loving God prevents us from loving our neighbors, then that love is broken. There's a story in the Talmud. Talmud is a book that is written to accompany the commandments. The 365 commands that are in the First Testament, the Talmud accompanies them. both with definitions and with stories. And it is ancient. And in it, there is a story about the law. And it's about two rabbis, Rabbi Shammai and Hillel. Rabbi Shammai and Hillel. And one day, someone came up to Rabbi Shammai and asked him to teach the whole Torah, so all the books of Moses, that's Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, all those books, teach me all of those books while standing on one foot. Well, Rabbi Shammai is like, that can't happen. He's actually angry to be asked such a question because it's so much teaching, you can't do it. So he chased away the person with a ruler. The same person goes to Rabbi Hillel and asks the same question. Can you teach me the whole Torah, all of those books, while standing on one foot? Rabbi Hillel says, what is hateful to you, do not do to your neighbor. This is the whole Torah. All the rest is commentary. Go and learn it. Everything else that we are called to be as Christians falls under this idea of loving God and loving our neighbor. And it's not just us as Christians. The golden rule, which you know, that's what this is, it's the golden rule, it's found in almost all of the other foundational faiths in the world. Jainism, one should treat all creatures in the world as one would like to be treated. Buddhism, treat not others in ways that you yourself would find hurtful. Native spirituality, we are as much alive as we keep the earth alive. Hinduism, this is the sum of duty. Do not do to others what would cause pain if done to you. Islam, no one of you truly believes until you wish for others what you wish for yourself. We're not alone. Humanity is striving for peace. We continue to teach and celebrate peace all over the world in all different ways, but obviously we haven't met it. Obviously we fall short. Sometimes I like to just imagine it though. I like to imagine a world if we actually did it. If everybody came together and actually did it, loved one another the way that we would like to be loved. Imagine what the world would be like without conflict. If the world was shalom, complete and whole and at peace. Imagine. Just imagine. This is the song, Imagine. John Lennon released this song almost 50 years ago. It was both praised and criticized. Many in the church took exception to his call for no religion. But as we've been reading the past several weeks from Matthew, Jesus had a problem with organized religion in his day too. He questioned their motives, their institutions, their teachings. We should do the same. They also had a problem with no hell and no heaven that it says in the lyrics. But Jesus called us to live for today, to make here the place of heaven. Now, so many saw then and still continue to see today this song, Imagine, as an anthem for peace. The lyrics ask us to imagine a world at peace without the barriers or the borders of division of religion and nationality, and to consider the possibility that everyone will live unattached to material possessions. World without conflict, complete and whole. Our next hymn, by popular request, has actions. So we have peace like a river. Peace like a river. I'll move over here. Peace like a river. You can say it in my soul, but I like to say in my soul. And then we've got
joy.
Joy like a fountain. Joy like a fountain in my soul. And then we've got love like the ocean. Love like the ocean in my soul. So, we're going to do this. He's going to help me, kid. Let us pray. O God, on this Sunday of peace, we seek to choose a life of nonviolence, to not harm others, to hear the voice that calls us beloved, to be compassionate, to choose right action, to cry out for righteousness. O God, give us the strength and the courage not only to believe, but to act, to recognize our own participation in the violence in the world and our need for change, to challenge the unjust and violent structures of our day, to gather time and again around the table of dialogue, to create and promote peaceful alternatives wherever we are, to continue to be a voice and a witness of nonviolence. Our journey through the doorway of peace begins with the steps we choose to take today, O God, but we ask that you be with us, that you guide us, that you love us into your love beyond measure. In Jesus, you have given us the tools to be builders of peace in our community, tools that craft peace built on love and justice, tools that shape communities built on human rights and respect, that build understanding and compassion for others, that create a world that delights in laughter and joy. We are inspired by your example to use our creativity, our ingenuity, our love of beauty, and the great work of building communities of love and hope. Guide us to embrace your ways as we continue your ministry of building peace in our world. God of compassion and caring, we pray silently for those that we hold in our hearts this day. Source of all light, we praise you for the wisdom of your word and the hope of your promises. With all your saints on earth and in heaven, we commit ourselves to the dawning of your new age. And we pray together as we were taught by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So now as we go out into the world, we go out into the world as people of peace, as people who are following the way of Jesus, as people who are loving God, loving all of creation with every fiber of our being, and loving our neighbor as we wish to be loved ourselves. We go now with the love of God, the peace of Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore. Amen.